Don't tell anyone this, okay? I sometimes get scared. send your voice throughout the night to sing your song with falling raindrops, to break your darkness with your light. You were born to show raw beauty, to wash the dirt from out their eyes. The whole world ran for cover when you opened up your skies. So you made your thunder silent, you learned to bite your rainy tongue. You gave them what they thought they wanted, you gave them endless sun. Watched as the leaves turned brown and dry, they wished they didn't take for granted your booming presence in the sky. You were born to be chaotic and be bold, to show there's beauty in the knowledge that you cannot be controlled. You might think that you're not needed, life without you is the same. Nothing beautiful would ever grow if it wasn't washed with rain.
to the rain. Rocks tumble, lurching their stone, shoulders and shuffling their stone. Feet down beds that drain the hill and become Monkey Run and Bailey Creek. Intimate as a distant friend.
From down here, and all through the world, he's so proud to be called. used to be the kind of guy who'd take pride in a tight and tidy woodpile. Logs sawed and stacked in an afternoon. Next morning, I'd be up in the dark to wet a hook. Now my days are a junk box of used to be's. A worker driving big trucks. Provider, free man. The injury and surgeries put an end to all that. Now I take, and more's taken from me. Now I push a pencil, sit in class with kids half my age, people twice as fast on anything with a screen. But like seeing a farm off the side of the road, seen through mist of an autumn morning, red barn over the round pen where horses circle, I'm beginning, just beginning, to see, if I can get through these classes, an easier life. Days of work that still leave me ready for t-ball with the boys. Weekends free of overtime. And the need, the constant need driving me. What I'll be, or who, I can't make out yet. So I just keep going. Just keep laying the miles down.
Thank you. standing on that stage, wind rippling my regalia, diploma overhead, I remembered the word chrysalis.
People think it's easy. A worm just crawls in and soon pops out a butterfly. The truth? Legs, face, back, underbelly, all recognizable features. They melt. There's no going back.
That's how it felt. Getting clean and coming up to the college. A terrible and necessary transformation. Nearly a breakdown.
It was a breakdown until I broke through. Wings are not guaranteed, my dad always said. They are earned.
Thank you. my head, on my head. In my arms, on my arms. I carry the war, but tell no one. No one but Jake, my service shepherd. I sometimes whisper to him.
The first time I flunked out, I was ashamed. The second, I had a job all lined up and did what I was told. But I had gifts I had no idea how to use. I only knew one thing. I was wasting my life. We save each other or die, and die alone. Life, my life, is worth living. I am not alone.
Ever since the accident, when the doc drilled into my skull, words blur. They swim in the space at the edge of the page. I squint. I blink. I bring them back. I take slow steps towards comprehension. Who can understand what TBI means?
Then Mom got sick. Melanoma. Dad had to work extra, so I basically nursed her. Funny how the worst of life can point to the best. I started at the community college, part-time, and now I snap on gloves, mask up, and enter the theater. There's a young man, lost, young, as I was when I was lost. Motorcycle accident. Who could see the man I've become, the surgeon in the aimless man I was? We save each other or die, and die alone. Life, my life, is worth living. I am not alone.
My one friend, in English, carried her brain injury back from tank duty. Helmets keep us both alive. I don't ride my bike anymore. Gotta get my kicks in other ways. Never thought I'd be in college. Don't think I could do it on my own. My friend's a vet, so she gets what loyalty means. Won't leave a wounded comrade, even in class. She drags me to safety.
From the first class when I saw scars crossing his skull, I knew I found a fellow traveler. Sitting with him calms me. It makes my life bearable. We owe our lives to each other.
Alexi. Decades ago, I sat in hard bleachers watching my kids down on the field. Here I am again in autumn sunshine, cheering on my grandkids. Cheering on my grandkids. Helmets and pads and the crash of impact these days make me flinch. When the defense comes on, I turn to my quizzes, my pile of grading, my companion for all these years, my faithful companion for all these years. A long line of faces, a parade of human potential, has passed before me in my classes for all these years. In my classes for all these years. The roar of the crowd lifts my gaze. Matthew himself is on a tear, angling for the sideline, closing in on their safety with speed to spare and open field. With speed to spare and open field. He crosses the 20, he crosses the 10. When he hits the end zone, ball aloft, he looks up my way and I wave. My heart huge, my heart huge. That's what I hope for, what I always hope for. As I turn again to my other kids, I know I've seen the befuddled and the lost. I've seen the lackluster and I've seen the lazy, but I want to see them struggle.
Want to see them struggle.
Then break from the scrum and take off. Then break from the scrum and take off. A long line of faces, a parade of human potential, has passed before me in my classes for all these years. In my classes for all these years. Through my life, through my life, a parade of greatness has passed right through me. Through my life, a parade of greatness has passed right through me. For all these years, has passed right through me. For all these years.
New to teaching, I thought what I knew was the key to freeing others. Then it was about the light of aha dawning on them, dawning in them. Now it's how these and more play into a distant and perhaps hidden flowering. Not yet the crocus in blossom, just the first stirring of green in last fall's leaves. I watched the world for signs and attend to transitions. I traffic in becoming.
Work or more school? I had no direction. So after graduation, I toured doing church camps and Sunday schools, skits and improvs about self-esteem and not being a bully.
Every week, a new venue, all looking for us to before, I still don't know. I repeated what I was told, but doing all those roles...
The drunk gardener, Little Miss First Dance, the girl with nothing to live for, I became my own person.
I greeted new pastors, host families, even whole youth groups. I looked everyone in the eye. I learned to be steady.
That year, my mom said I'd changed. Said for the first time, she was proud of me.
One time, 2 weeks before a real show opened, still on book and terrified, I stood alone on stage, mute. My drama teacher called out from the darkness.
You can't know what greatness is unless you touch the greatness in you.
That's been my compass, my map, my destination. I don't act anymore. Studied management instead.
But when the grant's due or the office is in a panic,
I feel that stage around me. All that space, I remember. What's inside me? What's always inside me? And I let it out.
We have no